Did you know that dev container templates are now available with Azure SQL Database? Learn all about them and how quickly you can get started with local development this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Carlos, a PM on the SQL team. Carlos, thanks so much for joining us today.
Hi, Anna. Thanks for having me. Really excited to be here in the show again. This time, I'll be sharing some updates in the developer space for Azure SQL Database.
Cool. I'm always excited to learn more about what we're doing in the developer space. Today, I know we're going to be talking about dev containers and the templates that we have and some new things we're doing with Azure SQL Database. But as a refresher for folks, can you share us a little bit, like, what's a dev container and why would I use it?
Of course. But before, let me share my screen. I have a few slides. And yeah, so before we dive into the topic of dev containers, I would like to touch a little bit on local development because this is important. So let's talk about this scenario. I'm a new developer in this team, and I have to build a new feature for an existing application. My application stack happens to be Node.js and Azure SQL. So I have to answer these two questions before I get started. Where do I code? That would be my local machine, or maybe the cloud, maybe using containers. And then I have to decide what I'm going to use. If I'm talking about containers, probably Docker. For my cloud editor, probably VS Code. But yeah, all good. But the problem is that when I share the code with my peers and they review it, they say, hey, Carlos, you have some problems. I cannot run this. So we ended up in this situation that it works on my machine, but I cannot ship my computer to our customers. So there is a better way to do this. And this is what dev containers aim to solve. So answering to your question, what is a dev container? It's a full containerized development environment that packs everything. So you have your tools, your libraries, your code base. So that means your programming language, and all these things are defined using what is called a dev container specification file, a devcontainer.json. And as you can see, the power of dev containers is that you can build your own templates. And this is what we are announcing today. So I'm very excited to share the news here that we created this collection of dev containers tailored for developers working with applications around Azure SQL Database. So this is what it comes with. So as you can see, VS Code and Docker is required. We need to have the dev container extensions installed in VS Code for sure. But it comes with a sample database. So it comes with different tools, different configurations specific for developers to get started really quick. And they can choose their favorite programming language, whether you are a .NET, .NET Aspire, Node, or Python developer, you can use these templates with using these languages. And the most important thing is that when you are ready with this local development that you can run your machine or in the cloud, you can transition to Azure using GitHub Actions to deploy the database, deploy your application using Azure Static Web Apps. So yeah, that's what dev containers are in a nutshell in the context of Azure SQL Database.
Wow, yeah. Awesome. This looks great. You know, Carlos, I'm sure folks would love to see it if you could show us, like, you know, how do I access these templates and how do I get started?
Absolutely. Let me jump into my VS Code environment. So what you see here is exactly what I described before, right? So I am a Node.js developer. I have my backend here and I have my front end using React. The problem is that if I start with this environment in my local machine, I don't have, for example, Node installed. I don't have SQL command installed. So I would have to go through the pain of installing all these things. I don't have a database. So yeah, I'm kind of stuck in this situation where I have to do everything myself. But the way we can get around with this using the dev container templates for Azure SQL Database is very simple. The first thing you have to do is that you have to have installed, you have to install the dev containers extension for VS Code. And once you have it, you have access to this command palette here on the bottom left, or in the command palette, you can type simply dev containers. And the first thing we have to do is to add a dev container configuration file to our project. So my project is already on source control. I'm using Git. So what I want to do is download the template and rebuild this environment in a dev container so I can get started really quick. So I'm going to proceed here. And then I got a couple of options. As I said, I'm version control ready. So I'm going to select this option. And the next step is to select the template I want to use. So what we are going to do here, we're going to click on show all definitions. And here you can see that we have a very long list of different templates. What I want to use is Azure SQL for sure. So what I'm going to do now is select the Node.js and Azure SQL template here. I'm going to go with the default version of Node. And here's the power of dev containers. So you can see that on top of that existing template, I can add additional features. I'm going to go with the default here. I don't want to add anything else. And in a moment, you will see that something had happened. And VS Code is even asking me to reopen everything in a container. I don't want to do that right now because I want to go through the different things that get added to my project. So in the beginning, it was just the application, right? But now I have this dev container definition that let me just zoom out. And this is nothing more than the template that I was talking about. Here is Node.js and Azure SQL. You can see that it comes with a specific settings to make it easier. So this is a setting for the VS Code extension of the SQL Server on this code. So here I can just double click and connect to my database because my connection string is already configured for me. We're using environment variables to obfuscate the passwords. It comes with a selection of extensions. So that means that I will be ready to go with the most popular Node.js and Azure SQL extensions in VS Code. It includes a pre-created sample database, and this is the command that is making that possible. So after the container starts, it kicks off this customized script that builds the database for me. Of course, you can change this up, but this is just a way to get started really quick. And as you can see, the features, it includes some Azure CLI and more. So yeah, let's take a look at how it looks once the container is built. So all I need to do is like reopening the container. As you saw it before, it's just that simple. It will go through the process of building the image and getting things ready for me. But in the end, this is how it's going to look. So it looks pretty much the same, right? But here's the difference. Let's jump into the SQL Server extension for VS Code. Let's double click here and connect. And you will see that I have a database. So it comes with a sample database, as I mentioned. Part of these templates are leveraging SQL database projects to validate the code you are building against your target. And we hope the target is Azure SQL database. So you can see I have my project definition. I can add new tables if I want. So let's add a new table called collections here really quick. And let's let's go with the default here. This means that I can make changes to this existing database here. And if you want to query the database and build the new changes into the database projects or publish these changes into your local environment, we created a set of tasks that are predefined. So you can see that I'm using the VS Code task command. And the first command that I see on the screen is to verify my data. So it's just a matter to run this query here, and it will return the data that already exists on this sample database. So as you can see, it's not empty. It's a living database here that I can modify. If I decide to apply the changes I made to my database, because you can see the collections table is not here yet, I have to go through the process of building the database project. So it includes the task, and then I have to publish the changes locally. So just to show you that this is an entirely working environment, I already have my backend and frontend running. So you see here, Node is running. So I can jump into my app really quick and show you that I have an API that returns data using that authors and also the books table. And here's my application. You can tell that front end design is my passion. So if I want to introduce myself as a new author, I can do it because the database is fully functional. And if we query the database again, we'll get the results as expected. So again, it's very easy. As you said, it comes with all these things pre-built for us. And it's just a matter to start using the templates from VS Code. Yeah.
Wow, this is amazing. Personally, I just saw a lot of things and you were able to do it so quickly. I was playing around the other day and I feel like this would have been so much easier if I had one of these. So it's awesome to see that this is out. I had two quick comments I wanted to make for you. One, it was so cool how while you were deploying the dev container, you had that option to be like, okay, what else do you want in this container? Because, you know, maybe there's other things that I know I'm going to need for my application. And then that it knew like, oh, okay, you created this. Let's just get you into a VS Code environment like that. Super amazing. The second question I had for you is maybe a silly question, but like, you said Azure SQL Database, right? So like, how are you accessing Azure SQL Database locally?
Oh yeah. So what the project is doing is that the validation of the project occurs for the target. So all my code, everything that I'm doing for that local database will be compatible with Azure SQL Database. And we're working on some new additional things that hopefully I will be able to share here in the future. But yeah, that's how it works.
Cool. Awesome. That makes a ton of sense. Okay. So now back to the other question is, you know, I think you have some of them up here, but like, what are the key benefits in your perspective of using a dev container?
Yeah, I jump in too fast, but yeah, I was excited to share this because it's important. So as you can tell, those templates are very handy. So it can be modified, but it brings consistency. So as a development team, I want my team to be able to work on my application stack, have everything pre-configured, ready to go. So we don't run into a problem that it works on my machine, right? So it should work as this, the same as any other environment. It is cost efficient because you can do your local development using Code Spaces, for example. GitHub Code Spaces comes with a free tier. You can just use a simple Docker environment for that. And it makes the transition seamless to Azure. So as you mentioned, you asked me, how do we do the Azure SQL Database locally possible? We're using containers for sure. The code that we are putting into the database and packaging everything using SQL Database projects will make easier the transition because you can grab that same project and just deploy it to Azure SQL Database really easy.
Cool. Awesome. So my final question is, as folks are getting started, like any final tips or tricks?
Yeah, what I would encourage our developer community is to try this out, to share some feedback. We're open to collaboration. This is an open source project. You can find all the links in the video description below. And yeah, that's all I would ask the community to try out and give us some feedback.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Carlos. To our viewers, check the links in the description to learn more and try this out. Leave us a comment and let us know what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.